This is Marcus Korva with Studio MMA and MMA Net, and we're here with Strikeforce heavyweight tournament finalist Danny Cormier. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling good, man. I haven't seen you guys since Dallas. It was my first big show, you know? Now I'm in the finals of this tournament. I never even thought it possible.
It's so funny, actually. We were sitting there, we were watching all the open workout, and me and Omar Boach from Sweden as well, for Pancrase, watching you. We're like, damn, he's supposed to be a wrestler. Look at his boxing. And we both said the same thing. That's a future prospect. And you showed that night, it's not just wrestling. It was a boxing performance against a tough Jeff Monson who took a beating that night. And you said, actually, we asked you, one of the questions was, if you had a chance to step into that tournament, would you take it? Do you feel you're ready? You didn't seem 100% sure. And then you go out and knock out Bigfoot Silva. Where are you at today?
I'm happy the way it played out. You know, I wasn't sure. I mean, it was my first time fighting up against somebody like Jeff, you know, so I was kind of coming down from the win and knowing that I had been improving. But to go into that tournament would have been a whole nother level above that, you know, and I had just prepared for somebody like Jeff Monson, and it was amazing, you know. So I wasn't sure exactly, but it turned out well for me.
Yeah, you can say that. And obviously, you said you've been working on your stand-up, you look like a boxer, heavyweight boxer in there. And one of the questions today here at the press conference with Kane and Junior Dos Santos was they're saying they're not powerhouse, not that big. You're a heavyweight, and you were saying the same thing. It's not always size and power, it's also about speed. Yeah. How do you look at this fight, the matchup?
Oh, it's a great fight, man. You got the two best guys in the world, you know, hands down. They've shown it. Junior dominated Shane Carwin, who was widely considered one of the top five guys in the world. Kane beat Brock when he was number one in the world and has wins over other guys, too. So their performances have shown that they are the two best heavyweights in the world. They're not big guys. You know, they're 240, 245. You know, you don't have to be a monster to fight in this division. So it's a great fight. Both guys have advantages. I think Junior's probably the better boxer. Kane's got great boxing skills also, good kickboxing skills. But again, advantage is wrestling. You know, Kane's wrestling is probably the biggest gap between skill sets in the fight. So him being able to determine where the fight takes place is going to be the key.
You being an Olympic level wrestler and being part of the same camp as Kane, AKA, how big part of his training camp have you played for this fight?
A decent part. Not as big as Brock because of my injury and the Bigfoot fight. Wasn't able to spar with him. But I've been able to wrestle, work wrestling with him, drill wrestling. We still get together on Saturday mornings and work on technical skills, game planning for the wrestling aspect of the fight. And just hanging out. You know, I can just be a friend. And he can use me where he needs me, you know. And this camp has been the wrestling.
We asked both Dana, Kane, and Junior Dos Santos if this fight will go five rounds. Do you think it will go five rounds?
No, I don't think it's going to be five rounds. These guys hit too hard. And also, it takes too much cardio to go five rounds with Kane Velasquez. And I'm not sure Junior can do that. You know, I think he's going to have his moments because he's a great fighter. But to go five rounds with Kane Velasquez is really tough. And with all the wrestling and all the grappling and the punching and the relentless pace, I think Kane's going to end up stopping him somewhere in the third or fourth round.
Good prediction. I appreciate that. So you're in the final. You're supposed to fight Josh Barnett. And there's been, you know, there's rumors. There's people talking about Strikeforce, the heavyweight tournament. Anything you want to say about that? How do you feel about it?
Oh, man, I hope the fight comes. I want to fight. You know, I want to fight Josh Barnett. It's a huge fight for me, another step up. I like big-time competition. You know, obviously, you know, Olympic Games and World Championships every year in wrestling. I like big-time competition, and fighting Josh Barnett is a huge step up for me. And also, it's just like the logical next step in my career. You know, I have to continue to build and continue to win big fights.
Josh Barnett in the finals, if that fight doesn't happen with Strikeforce, there's also rumors about perhaps, you know, Strikeforce and UFC merging. Not overseeing Josh Barnett at all, but is anyone else out there you want to fight? You watch them, you say, that's a test. That's a skill set test for me.
Yeah, stern test, man. Anybody in the top 10. Those guys are all tough tests. You know, they're step-ups for me and experience and skills, you know. So I'd like to test myself against the best guys, you know, Shane Carwins and the Nogueras, you know, those guys. I want to fight the best guys in the world in my area, you know, and then eventually get to the top where I'm fighting the Brock Lesnars and Alistair Overeem, you know, and those guys.
Being part of the training camp of the heavyweight world champion, does that inspire you? Does it help confidence-wise being in there and having a chance to mix it up, knowing at what level you have to be at to be a world champion.
Oh yeah, definitely being able to see it. You know, we have a few guys training at the championship level. Kosh just got finished training for a championship fight, obviously didn't win, but I was able to see him train for it. Watching Kane prepare for these two fights has been great. And also it gives me confidence going into the cage. You know, if you train with number one every day, it takes care of two, three, four, five, six, and everybody else down the line. So it gives me confidence when I step into the cage and when I fight these other guys.
Pleasure talking to you, Daniel. Thank you very much. I'm really looking forward to seeing more of you in there.
Yes, I appreciate it.
Always a really nice guy. Always a pleasure being with him. And one last question. Josh Barnett's little speech before his last fight. Did you see that? At the open workout?
In Dallas?
In Dallas, yeah.
Yeah, that was crazy. Professional wrestling.
Yeah, did you watch it?
Yeah, I watched it.
You up and coming and being out there, you're a real nice guy. Are we going to see any craziness from you as well?
No. I'll keep it the way it's always been. It seems to be working for me. I'm not going to go outside of myself. I'm just going to be me. You know, hopefully that's enough.
It's definitely enough. Thank you very much.
No problem, man. Thank you.
Thanks.